Friday, St. Peter's.
I'm Gautam Mayam.
And I'm Luke Bonifacio. And welcome to the Eagle Minute. Before we start our news broadcast, let's please stand for the prayer. And let's remember we're in the holy presence of God. In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, Amen. St. Peter, pray for us. St. John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever. And let's keep in mind all those who might be sick, sad, or alone this Christmas. Let us pray that they find peace throughout this holiday season.
And now for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, as a republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Seems like a lot happened since our last episode before Thanksgiving.
Seriously, that Thanksgiving Eve game and pep rally seems so long ago.
Not only did the basketball team dominate against Curtis, but they also beat C last night, improving their island record to 3-0.
Wow, they're off to a great start. Why don't we take a look at some of those highlights?
And hello, ladies and gentlemen, and good evening from what is the site of the 65th annual Thanksgiving Eve Classic from the College of Staten Island between two storied institutions not more than 1 mile apart here. It is the visiting St. Peter's Eagles taking on the hosting Curtis Warriors.
Slide on, post it up with the militia. Ain't switching, mind on missions, mind on. Bring on the problems. Bring on the problems. Bring on the problems. Bring on the. Only sign in the game. We the new Lucian Grange. Bring on the reins. A MJ thing. I'm talking to Brady thing. I'm off of the juice. Never could say go to mix. Rocking the biz on a twist. Step up, he can't comb. Not acting like Christians in here. But Christian Dior and they homes. The bigger we get. Gotta thank God for this. I got a lot that I give. I be handing out gifts like the Christmas on 25th. Out in the 20s. Inside of the 20 inch set. I would buy the jet before I could afford it. Now I got the jet building the landing strip. In the back of the crib, I record the hits. In the front of the crib, they valet the whips. Breaking the records, more money, more problems. They come with the status. Running through customs when you run to Alice. I got accustomed to custom the fastest. I'm talking about fabrics, I'm talking about mattress. I never sleep, though I sleep with a baddie. I'm moving deep, cause that's just how I sat in it. But if you come out, just be ready for action. Just needed some time, was set on my time. Now they see the signs. You didn't leave me solo right here all alone. You held it down for me right on my own. Yeah, get it, just try to get home. I got a Rolodex all in my phone and it's still. I've been out late night, creeping, trying to slide on. Posted outside with militia. Ain't switching, mind on mission. Mind on in billions, mind on in billions.
A final score, Curtis 29, the St. Peter's Eagles 48.
Bring on the problems, bring on the problems, bring on the problems. They say more money, more problems. Bring on the problems, bring on the problems, bring on the.
What an amazing game.
Team has another game tomorrow at Iona, too.
Best of luck to them.
The wrestling team and the hockey team just started their seasons recently.
Shout out to junior Vincenzo Maioro, who just started the powerlifting team, under the leadership of Coach Smith.
We also had a major success with the toy drive. We donated over 100 toys.
Next week, we have a short week, with Mass on Monday and the Christmas Assembly on Wednesday.
Let's not forget about the tree lighting tonight at 7.
I'll be there. Let's go down to Alex Chi to hear from the students. And how they feel about Christmas being right around the corner.
Over to you, Alex.
Good morning, St. Peter's. I'm your Secretary Alan Shee, and today we're back on another episode of STP News Hallway Talk. And this episode is a little bit different. It's Christmas themed, and as you can see, we got the national toy drive going on this year, annual toy drive. And I got a couple questions for some fellow students here. First, I got, Senior Luke Tarantino, he, as you can see, is participating in No Shave December, looking great. How are you feeling today?
Feeling pretty good.
So I got a couple questions for you. First question is, with Christmas coming up, what is the gift that you're looking most forward to, and what did you ask for?
So I asked for a new hand. Hopefully somebody could put that through the works for me and get it done, but I don't know. Just hoping.
All right, so today is National Stupid Toy Day. What is the most stupid and pointless toy, in your opinion, that's ever been invented before?
I'd have to go with a yo-yo.
Yo-yo, that's a solid answer and very pointless. Thank you for your time. Have a good day.
Yeah, you too.
I gotta look for someone else to here we go.
Oh,
this is Sandy. How you feeling?
Feel good.
No. Ready to interview?
Hell yeah. Let's do it.
So I got a couple questions for you. First, we're basically halfway, a little more than halfway through the football season. What's your Super Bowl, early Super Bowl predictions?
Dallas Cowboys all the way. We're taking it this year. It's all you, baby. It's all you.
Says every Dallas Cowboy fan every year. Next, what are you looking forward for Christmas? Like, what are you asking for, basically?
Definitely one of those, like, squishmallow things, you know, like... This thing!
Alright, that was the Santa for you guys. Next, oh, here we go!
So,
I'm here with Junior Matt Orso. How are you feeling today?
Hey, not good.
Not great? Alright, so, do you watch basketball?
I do watch basketball.
So, there's a lot of controversy going on, who's the best player in the NBA? You know, you got Giannis, you got Luka. Who, in your opinion, is the best NBA player right now?
Jason Tatum.
Jason Tatum?
Yeah.
All right, that's an interesting one, but he's Patrick.
Top two. All
right, that's up. Lastly, National Toy Day, National Stupid Toy Day. What's the most stupid and pointless toy, in your opinion?
Fidget spinner.
Fidget spinner?
Never got it.
Yo, I love that answer. Everyone, a lot of things. All right, this is a different segment of STP News Hallway Talk. And I will see you guys next time.
I'm probably getting cold from Santa this year.
Maybe it'll do better next year.
Hopefully. Maybe the weather will be better this year.
Well, let's check in with our local meteorologist, James Woodford, for his weather update.
Over to you, James.
Looks like it's getting cold.
Well, you heard it.
Winter is coming.
Dress warm, everybody.
It's true. It's only 5 more days until winter.
Today is B-Day.
And since it's a B-Day, I think we should give some B-Day shout-outs.
Good idea. Happy B-Day to Kevin Riley.
And Rob Luciola.
Let's see what the quote of the day has to offer them.
Let them eat cake. At least that's what Marie Antoinette said.
Interesting. You know who else needs a shout out?
Who?
Junior Colin DeFusco.
That's right. He won this year's writing contest.
I think his name will be put on the plaque in the hallways.
That's great. Congrats, Colin.
Better luck next year, everybody.
Since we're doing shout-outs, I think it's important that we shout-out our one and only Pablo for all the hard work he does here at St. Peter's.
Yes, let's go see what's popping with Pablo.
Oh, watch your step. I'm mopping now. Do you have time for an interview real quick?
Oh, no, right now. Okay. Maybe later.
Maybe later.
Yes. Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Peace.
Well, maybe we'll get him next time.
Instead, let's go over to Brennan Blomquist and Marius Karlovich for an interview with a special guest who came to St. Peter's the other day.
Over to you.
I'm here today with Eric Davis, the one and only. How you doing today?
I'm doing great, man.
Can you just, you know, tell me a little bit about yourself, you know, what your career entails?
Yeah. So I'm the director of content and social media for Fandango and also Vudu. And so Fandango, we sell movie tickets. And then on Vudu, you can buy and rent movies at home. And then I also sort of arrange all of our celebrity interviews, all of our exclusive content that we debut across our platforms. I also run all of our platforms on social media. We just launched on TikTok at Fandango. I'm going to plug that. But then I also do a bunch of interviews. I go on TV. I go on the radio. And so, you know, I like to consider myself kind of a jack of all trades. And so anything that needs to be done as you know, entailed with covering movies and selling movie tickets and selling movies online, you know, I kind
of. Yeah. Also, since it's near the end of the year, which movie do you think is probably the best of all time?
The best of all time or the best of this year?
Best of this year.
Well, I mean, if you're asking me, like, my favorite movie of the year, it's Top Gun Maverick. I think that movie's awesome. I think it just kind of, it delivers on every level that a movie can deliver. Which I love, and even if you didn't see the original Top Gun, I think it's still an awesome experience. And so that, to me, I think is the best movie of the year.
Now, since Black Panther Wakanda Forever is the last movie for Phase 4 of the MCU, do you think that movie was a perfect ending for that phase?
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting because Marvel, if you're a Marvel MCU fan, I think a lot of MCU fans are looking for, like, what that first era, that first saga gave us, where it was like Thanos was introduced very early on. We knew that it was building to fighting him. And now, like, so far, Phase 4 has been kind of like these solo stories that haven't necessarily felt like they were connected to a bigger kind of saga.
Cool. It was interesting hearing from a professional movie commentator and all.
All I know is that Avatar 2 is coming out tonight.
I know. I can't wait.
I can't wait for Christmas.
Isn't there anyone who knows what Christmas is all about?
Please, I know you're busy. Use your bag of tricks. We haven't been naughty. At the news, we've been good. Please, we work constantly. We work day and night to produce the news for our St. Peter's students, for our school. We need your help. Are you able to do it for us? Don't give me that face. Come on. Please. I know you can help us. Is there anything you can do?
Ho, 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 ho. We'll see what we can do for you.
Can I please have your attention?
A brief discussion, if you will, about the beautiful day of things that don't exist. Such as gremlins, Bigfoot, even little elves. They don't exist. Ho, ho. And what about men from Mars? Well,
oh my God, he's back.
Look at that. No, cut that out. There will be no discussion about that. And one very annoying topic. Is the front of all this controversy is a Christmas guy who calls himself the Dark Reader. There'll be none of that discussion.
What?
Oh no, not again. Not again. He can't be. He was here already.
I think that countdown is for Christmas.
9 days until Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Enjoy the holidays. I'm Luke Bonifacio.
I'm Connor Monahan.
Tune in next time on the Eagle Minute.